Good evening, everyone. I'd like to welcome you all to the Pleasant Valley High School Academic Awards Ceremony. While this is our 39th annual ceremony, it is our first ever digital production. Tonight, our celebration looks a little different. Instead of sitting in this very auditorium with a belly full of the best quiches and chicken fingers that you can get in the West End, you watch from home. And these two words, from home, you've become quite accustomed to. For the last 2 months, you've traded classrooms, whiteboards, and desk chairs for living rooms, Chromebooks, and lazy boys. Instead of hustling down the G hallway to make sure you aren't late for your English class, you're hustling to reset your internet router to make sure you're not late to your next Zoom session. It is truly unprecedented how things have changed so drastically, so quickly. But tonight, we aren't here to dwell on what's changed. Tonight, we're here to celebrate what hasn't: hard work. Teaching and learning has never been more challenging than it currently is in distance learning. Everything takes longer and requires much more patience. But through all the challenges it presents, you all have managed to stay at top of your game and be the very, very best students you can possibly be. You didn't become this group by luck or fate. You became this group through late nights, lots of reading, lots of researching, sacrificing social events, and prioritizing learning over everything else. And let's not forget to recognize your parents. They were the ones that pushed you early on to develop those habits and behaviors and shape your mindset. No matter your success and what you achieve moving forward, don't ever forget the people that helped to get you there. Always remember to be humble and always remember to be appreciative. Before we get started, I'd like to recognize and thank our district administration for providing the leadership, mentorship, and support we need to strive to be the highest achieving high school we can possibly be. I'd like to recognize and thank our school board for supporting us in our goals to provide the very best possible education we can for our students and for putting in the selfless amount of time that you do week in and week out. I'd like to recognize our great team of administrators here at Pleasant Valley High School. Mr. Hines, Mrs. George, and Mr. Sodal. These three run the building every day, are fantastic leaders, and I'm very grateful for them. I'd like to thank my secretary, Mrs. Finnemore, who organizes this event every year. And lastly, I'd like to thank Mr. Morris for recording tonight's event and putting this production together for your viewing pleasure. With that being said, let's get started. I'm sure by now you're thinking we've seen enough of this guy's face. So we've asked our department chairs to join us from their homes to present their awards. So without further ado, I'd like to introduce our chair of the art department, Mr. George Budman.
Good evening and welcome to this year's Academic and Visual Arts Award ceremony. And it is a unique situation for us this year as we are all home and enjoying ourselves and our family during this crisis. I hope everyone's well and looking forward to getting outside a little bit as the weather comes around. To start off this year, we have the academic awards for the art and computer science classes, and we have broken it up into two sections. First, the art academic awards go to the seniors are Brenna Howe, Katie Hicks, and Piper Clifford. The juniors are Leilani Chung, Madison Gaddy, and Asara Pleas. Under computer science, which consists of AP Computer Science Principles and Project Lead the Way Computer Science Essentials, we have seniors Kyle Smith, Nathan Siegel, and Stefan Ginn. For juniors, we have Brandon Coyle, Brandon Dolan, and Giuseppe Carbone. Moving on to the Visual Arts Awards. This year is no different than others. We have every year we have great students that want to go on and pursue art as a career. And this year is no different than any others. This year we have awards for creativity and mixed media, and this year that goes to Astera Please, Owen James, and Sarah Tartalega. In under digital art, we have Leilani Chung, Olivia Getz, and Piper Clifford. For drawing and painting, we have Katie Hicks, Madeline Schaefer, and Tabitha Andrews. Under art exploration, which is kind of a discovery segment that students go above and beyond and looking for something new as opposed to just looking for a grade. And this year, those students are Edwina Alexis, Halusi Seaton, and Madison Gaddy. We have, again, the Most Promising Young Artist Award this year, Sarah Please as a junior, Jenna Zarilli as a 10th grader, and Lishka Soto-Semedi as a freshman. This year, we have a special student that is going on for art education who has received the Best Overall Portfolio Award, and that student this year is Brenna Howell. Thanks for all the students and parents, for everybody who has done a great job this year, and hope to see you next year.
Thank you, Mr. Budman. It's great to see you in the confines of your own home. I'd like to introduce...
Oh my God, what's going on? Where's this suit? Where's the backdrop? Where's the new auditorium? What is happening, Mr. Triolo? Well, take one was in the new auditorium with my suit and with Mr. Hines and Mrs. George and Mr. Sodal. And when you forget to introduce somebody, this is what you get. This is what we call take two in a polo in my office. So, at this time, I'd like to introduce Mr. Dan Mulligan, who is going to present the National Art Honor Society Awards. Take it away, Mr. Mulligan.
The National Art Honor Society Outstanding Service Award goes to a student who goes above and beyond in giving back to the community. Each year, we look for a student who donates his or her time with cheerfulness and enthusiasm, using art to make the world a better place. This year's winner is Dominic Tyner. Dom's friendly and encouraging personality is the perfect mix for an ambassador of the arts. Whether he was volunteering for a day teaching crafts to children at Bethlehem's Celtic Classic, or making kids smile as he painted their faces at PV's community trick-or-treat night. Dom's easygoing personality and passion for the arts and his willingness to go the extra mile makes him a logical recipient of this award. Congratulations, Dom.
This time I'd like to introduce the chair of our business department, Miss Melissa Ruschak.
Good evening. I am Melissa Ruschak, and I am the department chair of the business department. It is my honor to announce the 2019-2020 Business Department Awards. But before I do, I would like to congratulate all the recipients tonight. I would also like to give a big shout out to all the seniors out there. Good luck, dream big, keep moving forward, and know that we are all so proud of you. Now for tonight's Business Department Awards. The 9th grade award goes to Maria Sayeda. The 10th grade award goes to Joshua Haynes. The 11th grade award goes to Briella Kish. And the 12th grade award goes to Gavin Winders. Again, congratulations and thank you.
Thank you very much, Ms. Ruschak. At this time, I'd like to introduce the chair of our English department and our yearbook advisor, Mrs. Philomena Reduzzi.
Good evening and welcome to the Academic Awards. It is my pleasure as the Department Chair for English to acknowledge the top scholars in their respective grade levels. These students have achieved the highest averages in their grade over the course of their study. Recognizing 9th grade honors English, top scholars Cassidy Shoup and Isabella Barron. For 10th grade honors English, the top scholars include Zachary Duner and Jacob O'Neill. In 11th grade AP Language and Composition, the acknowledgement goes to Emma Barrett and Kylie Ramsey. And in the 12th grade AP Literature and Composition, the students with the highest overall averages are Emily Geffen and Ethan Fisher Perez. Congratulations to all of you for your hard work. As the yearbook advisor, I would like to acknowledge the students who have dedicated their time and energy to producing the 2020 yearbook. I usually use the academic awards to acknowledge the seniors who have spent several years on staff producing the yearbooks. And so this year, having to step it up to complete a yearbook from home, I want to acknowledge not only the senior staff members, but also the underclassmen who have really stepped it up, who have tried to get pictures while staying at home, who have contacted me on various occasions about what to do and when to do it. And so without them, the 2020 yearbook really would never have come to fruition, which, by the way, it hasn't yet because we're still working on it. And if anybody's still interested in purchasing a yearbook, they are still available. Just simply go to justinsyearbook.com. How's that for commercial? Anyway, I definitely want to recognize the following students. Senior Katie Altimos, Senior Tegan Angel, Senior Dana Gimlet, Senior Bethany Hadda, Junior Briella Kish, Senior Emelina Crowder, Senior Giovanni Marini, Senior Madison O'Neill, Junior Amanda Roleri, Junior Danielle Romanowski, Senior Madeline Schaefer, and freshman Cassidy Shoup. Thank you so much for your persistence and your tenacity in trying to finish the yearbook. Everyone, have a good evening.
It's great to see you, Mrs. Reduzzi. At this time, I'd like to introduce the chair of our Family and Consumer Science Department, Mrs. Julie Terziva.
Hello, I'm Julie Terziva, Department Chair for the Family Consumer Sciences Department, and I'm happy to announce the award recipients for our department. Each year, our department chooses four recipients, one for each grade, and the person is chosen based on their overall grade and the number of classes they've taken in our department. All of our recipients this year have taken multiple courses within our department and excelled in them. Our ninth grade recipient is Maria Saida. Our sophomore recipient is Alexa Weaver. Our junior recipient is Sarah Tartaglia. And our senior recipient is Caitlin Gonzalez. Congratulations.
Great job, Mrs. Terziva, and it was very good seeing you. At this time, I'd like to introduce the chair of our Industrial Technology Department, Mr. Rich Petrushka.
Hello everyone, I'm Mr. Petrushka and I'm in my own personal wood shop here to present the Industrial Technology Department Academic Awards. On behalf of myself, Mr. Meckes, and Mr. Stauffer, we're very pleased to present the following awards. For Medal 1, Summer Storm, congratulations Summer. Medal 2, Kyle Smith, congratulations Kyle. Medal 3, Justin Galarza, congratulations Justin. For Wood 1, Jake Gethin, congratulations Jake. Wood 2, Amanda Hook, congratulations to you Amanda. Wood Mastery, Megan Knappenberger, congratulations Megan. And for the first time this year, a Vex Robotics Academic Award goes to James Syracuse, congratulations James. I really wish I was there to shake everyone's hand and pat you on the back for a job well done. Mr. Meckes, Mr. Stauffer, and myself are very proud of your accomplishments, as you should be also. Please enjoy your awards. We wish you all well, and we really, really hope to see you all personally very soon. Have a great night. Congratulations.
Mr. Petrushka, can I borrow that tool on your back wall there? I really could use that, but thank you very much, Mr. Petrushka. At this time, I'd like to introduce our journalism advisor, Mrs. Jacqueline Brinker.
This year's journalism awards go to seniors Ryan Perger and Isabella Seeprasad, and junior Sydney Umstead, next year's editor-in-chief. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Brinker. At this time, I'd like to introduce our math department chair, Mr. Ken Pointowski.
I'm Mr. Pienkowski, here to present the Pleasant Valley Mathematics Department Awards for this school year. The math department awards students in each of the honors level courses as well as the AP level courses. The winners are determined by the highest average in those classes through the first three marking periods. The Honors Algebra 2 award, there's a tie. The award goes to Julia Gower and Jordan Couch. Our Honors Geometry award goes to Jacob O'Neill. The Honors Trig Pre-Calc award, also a tie, goes to Ernest Gower and Cassidy Shull. Our AP Statistics Award goes to John Barry. The AP Calculus AB Award goes to Ryan Rodriguez. And the AP Calculus BC Award, also a tie, goes to Nate Siegel and Ethan Fisher Perez. In addition to each of our class awards, we also award the AMC contest winners at each grade level. The AMC is a national exam that is given to all students across the country, and we award our top scores in the high school. The AMC 10 winner is Donald Francois, and the AMC 12 winner is Nate Siegel. Congratulations to all award winners.
Thank you very much, Mr. Poinkowski. At this time, I'd like to introduce the Supervisor of Student Services of Monroe Career and Technical Institute, Ms. Amy Thomas.
Hello, my name is Amy Thomas, and I'm the Supervisor of Student Services at the Monroe Career and Technical Institute. Congratulations to all the outstanding students being recognized. Your accomplishments are truly remarkable. It is my privilege to recognize the three students with the highest overall averages at MCTI for their grade level. In grade 10, we have Patrick Hughes in Computer Information Science. In grade 11, we have Elijah Asilian in Graphic Communications. And finally, in grade 12, we have Brandon Bonifetti, also in Graphic Communications. Congrats again. You have made us very proud.
Thank you very much, Ms. Thomas, for recognizing our MCTI students. At this time, I'd like to introduce Mr. James DeVivo, who will be introducing all of our band award winners.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the music portion of the award ceremony. Just a couple words about the band program and the students involved in the band. First of all, the band has been incredibly successful this year. In addition, we have so many talented musicians involved in the band, in both the concert band, the marching band, and our jazz band program. The marching band, for example, we had a school record increase in our score this season. We won two first place trophies, won many special awards, including best music, best marching, best visuals, best percussion section, best color guard section. So we've won lots of awards there. The concert band was on their way to an incredible spring concert. We were so much talent in those students, and they worked extremely hard. And the jazz band too, the same thing. We had played so many songs already and had worked our way to a pretty high level, even for the beginning of March. So I just want to present a few awards to our students. The first awards are going to one student in each grade is what we do. We will do one student in 9th grade, one in 10th, one in 11th, and one in 12th for the band, and this will be the concert band awards. In 9th grade, the award goes to Megan Checkle. In 10th grade, the award goes to Sean Droll. In 11th grade, the award goes to Kylie Ramsey. And in 12th grade, the award goes to Sarah Joseph. We also have some other awards that we like to give out. Usually we do this at our Performing Arts and Visual Arts Award Ceremony, and they go to the Outstanding Soloist in the Concert Band, and that goes to Irina Milanese. Outstanding Soloist in the Jazz Band goes to Cameron Garmany. Outstanding Performance on a Brass Instrument, that goes to Ryan Anderson. Outstanding Performance on a Woodwind Instrument, that goes to Sarah Joseph. Outstanding Performance on a Percussion Instrument goes to Lauren Wiersba. Outstanding Instrumental Music Leadership goes to Sarah Fulper. And our final award, the Most Improved Instrumental Musician, goes to Alex Gabriel. Thank you. Have a good night.
Thank you very much, Mr. DeVivo. And at this time, I'd like to introduce Ms. Christina Shoemaker, who will be recognizing all of our Choral Award winners.
Congratulations to the following students receiving Performing Arts Awards for Chorus. Outstanding Soprano Performance, Aubrey Sawyer. Outstanding Alto Performance, Alila Thompson. Outstanding Tenor Performance, Joseph Janik. Outstanding Bass Performance, Jamari Mead. Outstanding Choral Leadership, Giovanni Marini. And Most Improved Choral Musician, Aaron Day. Congratulations to the following students receiving academic awards in the music department for chorus. 9th grade, Elijah Dunlap. 10th grade, Augustina Onobugu. 11th grade, Alexander Baldwin. And 12th grade, Giovanni Marini. Congratulations, guys.
Outstanding job, Mrs. Shoemaker. At this time, I'd like to introduce Mr. and Mrs. Mulligan, who are going to recognize all of our high school drama and musical award winners.
The Legend of Sleepy Hollow, based on the story by Washington Irving and adapted for the stage by Mary and Andrew Arnall, is set in 1790 in the small town of Sleepy Hollow, located on the shores of the Hudson River near Tarrytown, New York. In need of an itinerant teacher, the town calls on Ichabod Crane to fill the position. Crane has his eyes on the town beauty, Katrina Van Tassel, which infuriates her suitor, Brom Bones, setting up the story's dramatic ending with the Headless Horseman. This production ran from November 22nd through the 24th.
The award for Outstanding Performance by a Female Supporting Actor in a Play, Madison Jackson! Congratulations, Madison.
Congratulations.
The award for Outstanding Performance by a Male Supporting Actor in a Play, Zachary Smith! Congratulations, Zach. You were excellent in the role of Brom Bones. Outstanding Performance by a Female Leading Actress in a Play, Emily Geffen. Emily, you were fantastic as Katrina Van Tassel. And last, Outstanding Performance by a Male Leading Actor in a Play, AJ Long. Congratulations, AJ, in your role of Ichabod Crane. We're so proud of how hard all of you worked in the show, from the cast to the crew. Congratulations for a very successful run of The Legend of Sleepy Hollow.
Congratulations. Set in an island paradise during World War II, South Pacific tells two parallel love stories. Threatened by the dangers of prejudice in war, Nellie, a spunky nurse from Arkansas, falls in love with the mature French planter, Emile Debec. She learns that the mother of his children was an island native, and unable to turn her back on the prejudices with which she was raised, she refuses Emile's proposal of marriage. Meanwhile, the strapping Lieutenant Joe Cable denies himself the fulfillment of a future with an innocent Tonkinese girl, Liad, with whom he's fallen in love, out of the same fears that haunt Nellie. This production was to have run March 27th through the 29th.
The award for Outstanding Stage Crew goes to Alex Gabriel. The award for Outstanding Performance by a Female Supporting Actress in a Musical goes to Gianna Tufano for her role as Bloody Mary. The award for Outstanding Performance by a Male Supporting Actor in a Musical goes to Yoshi Janik for his role of Lieutenant Cable. The award for Outstanding Performance by a Female Leading Actress in a Musical goes to Emily Geffen for her role as Nurse Nellie. And last, but certainly not least, the Outstanding Performance by a Male Leading Actor in a Musical goes to Gio Marini for his role as Emile Debec. Congratulations to those five winners, but honestly, congratulations to the entire cast and crew. We know how hard everyone worked to have everything ready to go. We were so prepared even by March 13th. We look forward to seeing you again. We hope those songs of South Pacific and those amazing costumes and set will be seen sometime in the future. Until then, we hope that you all stay safe and healthy. We look forward to seeing you soon.
Yes, congratulations to all.
Just an outstanding job by the Mulligans, as always. And at this time, I'd like to introduce Mrs. Vanessa Fago, who is going to recognize our Shakey's Players Awards winners.
Hi, everybody. Shakey's Players began in 2000. Over the past 20 years, Shakey's has brought Shakespeare's most popular comedies and tragedies to life in Pleasant Valley, and provided an opportunity for students to tread the boards as Shakespeare's actors would have done. Unfortunately, due to the circumstances, Shakey's wasn't able to perform Julius Caesar. However, there were several members of Shakey's players who were involved in the planning and design of the play itself. And if Julius Caesar had been performed, I know it would have been successful because of each of them. The Service to Shakey's Award goes to individuals who chose to take on more responsibility than just acting in the play. They are the designers of our sets, our costumes, and our makeup and hair looks. They put in long hours of work and planning and work to overcome the unique challenges of live performance. The Service to Shakey's Award this year goes to Nathan Bozeman Johnson, Samantha Brooks, and Madison O'Neill. Fight captains have to design the fights, train the actors, and ultimately give the audience a thrill while keeping their actors safe. These three Shakey's players not only had important roles in the play, but they designed, learned, and taught several fights that I know would have been nothing short of epic. The Fight Captains Awards this year go to Ryan Anderson, Anthony Long, and Gianna Moreo.
Thank you, Mrs. Fago. At this time, I'd like to introduce the chair of our Health and PE department, Ms. Christine Constantopoulos.
It is my pleasure as the Health, Physical Education, and Driver's Education Department Chair to introduce the following students for not only their astonishing academic and physical performance, but these select students also demonstrated personal responsibility, character, integrity, and respect for others in the gymnasium and or classroom. In Driver's Education, we have Augustina Ngozi Anubugu. For Health 1, we have Ella Muir. Health 2, Jason Capsis. Physical Education, we have freshman Jacqueline James and Nathan Locke. Sophomores, we have Chloe Nelsley and Tyler A. Cobb. For juniors, we have Kylie Ramsey and Jack Kay. For seniors, we have Amelia Ginta-Baker and Matt Burnett. I hope you all live your best life while following these wise words from George Bernard Shaw. We don't stop playing because we grow old. We grow old because we stop playing. Thank you. Have a good evening.
Thank you, Ms. Constantopoulos. At this time, I'd like to introduce the chair of our science department, Mr. Dave Lewis.
Hello, my name is Dave Lewis, and I'm honored and privileged to represent our high school science department. Our science department awards the highest level students in each of our upper level courses, meaning they are enrolled in an honors class or an AP level class. All of these students have exemplified excellence in these challenging science classes. The following students are our science department winners. Honors Earth and the Environment is awarded to Cassidy Shupp. AP Honors Biology is awarded to Zach Dooner. Honors Chemistry class is awarded to Jackson Havens. Honors Anatomy and Physiology is awarded to John Berry. AP Environmental Science is awarded to Emma Barrett. And AP Physics is awarded to Nathan Seacall. Congratulations to all of our Science Award winners.
Great seeing you, Mr. Lewis. At this time, I'd like to introduce the chair of our History Department, Mr. Drew Dangler.
Hello, everyone. My name is Mr. Dangler, head of the Social Studies Department. On behalf of the Social Studies Department, I would like to offer congratulations to each of our Academic Award winners. Your dedication, hard work, and diligence toward your education is certainly to be commended. Here is a list of our award recipients. In U.S. History, Miss Julia Gower. Well done, Julia. In World History, Mr. Zachary Dooner. Great job, Zach. In American Government, we have co-winners, Mr. Jackson Havens and Miss Emma Barrett. Congratulations to the both of you. In Microeconomics, Mr. Nathan Seacole. Congratulations, Nathan. And in macroeconomics, again, Nathan Seacole. Nice job, Nathan. In modern U.S. and world history, Mr. Moises Loregi. Congratulations, Moises. In psychology, Miss Shyla Healy. Well done, Shyla. In human geography, Miss Tegan Engel. Congratulations, Tegan. In criminal justice, Miss Erin Smeraldo. Great work, Erin. In current issues, Mr. Evan Fisher Perez. Congratulations, Evan. And finally, in sports in society, Mr. Jake Alice. Well done, Jake. Congratulations to all of our award winners, and keep up the great work.
And at this time, I'd like to introduce the man who made this happen tonight, our videographer of this event, Mr. Craig Morris, who is going to introduce the Video Production Award winners.
Thank you, Mr. Joel. Glad I could help. The recipient of this year's Video Production One Award is Gianna Moreo. And the recipient of the Video Production Two Award is Anthony Long. Congratulations to you both.
Thank you very much, Mr. Morris. And at this time, I'd like to introduce the chair of our World Language Department, Ms. Miranda Ford.
Good evening. I'm Frau Ford, Acting Department Chair for the World Language Department, and I have the privilege to present to you the award recipients for the World Language Academic Awards this evening. Criteria for a student to receive the academic award in a world language course, German or Spanish, is as follows. The student has the highest or near highest average in the course based upon marking periods 1 through 3. The student is an active participant in class and has a genuine desire to learn the language according to the teacher of that course. The student makes an effort to use the language both within and outside of the classroom setting, and the student demonstrates talent for the language and displays promise to continue using the language in the future. First, the awards for Spanish. For Spanish 1, Jacob Wharton. Spanish 2, Adia Mercedes Gillum. Spanish 3, Augustina Onubogu. Spanish 4, Jackson Xavier Havens. And the awards for German, German 1, Alexandra Busch. German 2, Gabriella Pacarelli. German 3, Michelina Debska. And German 4, Hannah Stanhope. Congratulations to all our award recipients. Take care, have a great summer, and I hope to see you soon.
Thank you, Ms. Ford. It's my pleasure to recognize our Perfect Attendance Award winners for the 2019-2020 school year. These three students I'm about to name had not missed one day of school this entire year. Not one day, not an excused absence. They were in school from the first day of school until March 13th, and in today's day and age, that is extremely impressive. So I'd like to recognize our Perfect Attendance Award winners for this school year. Ninth grader, Kaylee Floor. 10th grader, Anthony Matera, and 10th grader, Augustina Onubogu. Congratulations. At this time, I'd like to welcome to the stage our Associate Principal, Mr. Robert Hines, to announce our National Merit Award winners.
Good evening, everyone. This is truly an outstanding award to present, and I'm very honored to have this opportunity to do this. Just a little background on the National Merit Scholarship Program. There are 1.6 million entrants. 50,000 of those 1.6 million are considered to be chosen for consideration. 16,000 of the 50,000 students are considered to be semifinalists. And the final round goes down to finalists being 7,500. Pleasant Valley is proud to have two of those 7,500 students nationwide. Those finalists for the National Merit Scholarship are Tegan Angel and Emily Gethin. It is now my pleasure to introduce the moderator of the FBLA, Ms. Denise Hopley.
Hello.
Hello, everyone. This is Mrs. Hoopley. I'm here to award the FBLA Awards for FBLA for this year. We've had a tremendous year this year in FBLA, and we thank everybody for their support. We have, of course, our principals and our school board and our administration, our superintendents that backed us 1,000% so we could be as successful as we were. So I'd like to introduce the following award winners, and congratulations and thank you very much for all your help and, of course, all your effort. I put everything up on Twitter because there were many awards that we did win as a chapter, and here we are awarding the individual events. The first one will go to Jordan McGrath. He will be representing FBLA for the fourth time this year. He got he was a state champion this year. We just heard the results the other night. He placed first in network design. He will be moving on to nationals for his fourth time representing FBLA. Tremendous, and he will be taking a test and pass through, hopefully, and then go on to a case study. Congratulations, Jordan. Our second person, that's going to be representing Pleasant Valley for nationals is Jackson Havens. He is second in the state of Pennsylvania. All of these kids competed against over about 100 or a little bit over 100 students to get these fabulous titles. So he is second in the state for journalism. He'll be representing Pleasant Valley in nationals. They're all virtual tests also. Third person representing Pleasant Valley at nationals is going to be Zachary Dooner. He was fourth in journalism, intro to FBLA. He, tremendous job. A lot of kids took the test. Fourth person who's going to be representing Pleasant Valley is Maria Saida. She was also fifth in the state of Pennsylvania for intro to FBLA also. So congratulations to these students. They'll be representing us very well. Another group of people who are receiving award, Olivia Karras, for her outstanding community service. She had over 947.5 hours this year in community service. She received second place honors in the state of Pennsylvania. She was also recognized nationally at the achievement level last year's, but she added to the totals, and so far she was over 1,400 hours representing Pleasant Valley and the state of Pennsylvania. The next three people have accomplished 500-hour level of volunteer hours, and they are Victoria Georgieva, Briella Kish, and Emma Barrett. These students will have received state honors for this accomplishment also. Pleasant Valley did a very good job this year, and they are first in the state for volunteer hours and fundraising. The next group of people is another special award for FBLA. It's someone who accomplishes all four levels of an achievement at the national level, which is very hard to do. We have many, many students who are reaching this level. They have accomplished and completed three of the four levels, and this is the highest achievement level that the national corporate office can award to a student. They need to complete Future Business Leaders, and then the final level is the American level, with Lishka Sota-Simetti will be receiving an FBLA award due to her accomplishments. Great job. Tyler Moore is also going to be receiving an award for his volunteer service. He's sixth in the state of Pennsylvania. Congratulations to Tyler, and you are going to be the award winner also. And that concludes the people that will be receiving awards this year at FBLA. We have many, many numerous awards and accomplishments that are up on Twitter. Please make sure you view them, and thank you very much.
Thank you, Mrs. Hopley, and congratulations on all the successes that FBLA has had this year and in previous years. At this time, I'd like to introduce Mr. Keith Haverstock to announce the Beth Paul Scholarship Award winner.
Good evening, and congratulations to all of this year's recipients. The officers and members of the Pleasant Valley Education Association commend you on your dedication and diligence in these trying times. You should all be very proud of yourselves and of your accomplishments. Each year, the Pleasant Valley Education Association awards the Beth Paul Memorial Scholarship to a graduating senior who will be majoring in a field of education. All too often, when people think about education, students talk about going into either the core subjects, elementary education, or special education. This year's recipient will be representing the arts. She will be attending Coastown University and will be majoring in art education. It is my privilege to present the 2020 Beth Paul Memorial Scholarship to this year's recipient, Miss Brenna Howell. Congratulations.
Always looking good, Mr. Haverstock. Thank you very much. It is now my pleasure to name the Principal's Award winner. This year's recipient of the award defines the word positivity. She truly is a ray of sunshine that walks our halls daily. Her personality is contagious, and she lifts the spirits of everyone around her. Not only is she nice, caring, and charismatic, she can sing, she can act and perform, and she also is one of our top achieving students in the senior class academically. I'm very happy to announce Emily Gethin as the 2020 Principal's Award winner. At this time, I'd like to welcome to the stage Mrs. Kelly George, Assistant Principal here at the high school, to introduce the Cyber Academy Award winners.
Thank you, Mr. Triolo. It is my pleasure now to announce the top Cyber Academy students at Pleasant Valley. Ninth grade, Olivia Zagroba. 10th grade, Tyler Carell. 11th grade, Coralina Winsko. And finally, 12th grade, Tristan Holden. Congratulations again. And now I'd like to introduce our assistant principal, Mr. Dave Sodal, to announce the top three students with the highest average for each grade level. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. George. It's my pleasure to introduce the top three students with the highest academic average for each grade level for the 2019-2020 school year in order from first to third. The top three seniors are Ethan Fisher Perez, William Serbone, and Emily Gethin. The top three juniors, Emma Barrett, Kylie Ramsey, and Jackson Havens. Our top three sophomores, Zachary Duner, Jacob O'Neill, and Alexa Pridham. And our top three freshmen, Cassidy Shoup, Julia Gower, and Sophia Tower. Congratulations to each and every one of you. And it is now my pleasure to reintroduce our Associate Principal, Mr. Bob Hines, to introduce our top 10 seniors. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Sodal. It's good to be back here on the stage. Once again, a very prestigious award for tonight are the top 10 students in the senior class. I will be announcing the top 10 in alphabetical order. Tegan Angel, John Berry, William Serbone, Ethan Fisher Perez, Emily Gethin, Michael Kearns, Canyon Marks, Ryan Rodriguez, Nathan Sokol, and Lauren Wurzba. Congratulations to our top 10 students, and that is based on cumulative GPA average. And it is now my pleasure to reintroduce Mr. Triolo.
Thank you, Mr. Hines. And now, the main event. The valedictorian is the student with the highest academic average throughout their high school career. And the salutatorian is the student with the second highest academic average throughout their high school career. It has been a long-standing tradition at Pleasant Valley High School that the Mattioli family, owners of the Pocono Raceway, give a $4,000 scholarship to our salutatorian and a $6,000 scholarship to our valedictorian. Before we name the valedictorian and salutatorian, we'd like to thank the Mattioli family for their continuous generosity over the years in awarding this scholarship to our students. They have done it for over two decades. Thank you. So without further ado, I will start by naming our salutatorian. Congratulations, John Barry, for being Pleasant Valley's 2020 salutatorian with a 103.619 cumulative average throughout his high school career. Great job, John. I will now name our valedictorian. Congratulations, Emily Gethin, for being named Pleasant Valley's 2020 valedictorian with an average of a 103.797 throughout her high school career. Congratulations, Emily. We are extremely proud of you both, and thank you for your hard work and effort over the years. It has certainly paid off. And this brings us to the end of our academic awards ceremony production. It was very bittersweet to have this ceremony tonight and not be able to see all your faces in the seats in front of me, but we are very happy to still be able to provide this opportunity for you and award your hard work, not just this year, but seniors throughout your entire academic career. If you did receive an award tonight, there will be a communication to you in the very near future about how you are going to receive those awards. And all I'd like to say to you now is please make good decisions, stay safe, stay healthy. We look forward to hopefully seeing you very, very soon. And congratulations to all of our award winners.